Hello everyone, so this is the last lecture of Unit 2 and in this lecture I will discuss about the transfer functions of separately excited DC motor. So DC motor based drive systems, they are widely used in applications requiring adjustable speed control. So for speed control actually you require to develop the transfer function of separate different blocks so that we can design the controller to achieve closed loop feedback control system. Okay. So here you can see we are having one DC motor and armature is fed from the control rectifier. If the supply is AC, so we are using control rectifier, but if the supply is DC, we can use DC-DC converters to regulate the armature voltage. Similarly, the field circuit is also fed from the control rectifier. This can be fed from uncontrolled rectifier or can be fed from the control rectifier. Then we are sensing the speed with the help of tacho generator. Then that speed is given to the, so from that speed we can generate what will be the back EMF, okay, and that can be compared and we can have error signal, then we can design the PI controller. Based on that we can decide what will be the firing angle. Okay, so this control circuit is deciding firing angle depending on the error signal. So first I'll derive the transfer function. So separately excited motor, we can represent something like this. So this is the armature circuit where we are having total armature resistance RA, armature inductance LA, back EMF EA and the applied armature voltage from the converter, it is VA. Okay, and we are having supply voltage, AC supply here, then we are having reference voltage. Reference voltage we are getting from the we have to set that reference voltage. Okay, then that reference voltage will be compared with the actual speed, actual voltage that is coming from the speed of the motor. And we are having a field circuit. Field circuit is having resistance RF and inductance LF, and the current is given is IF. VF is the voltage applied to the field circuit. So first I'm discussing here only armature voltage control. Okay, that means the voltage speed control below rated speed, and field control is applied when we require speed control above rated speed. Okay, so armature voltage actually nothing but some gain from the converter. Then what will be the reference voltage? So VA is given by KC, KC is some gain, then VR. So first we have to determine what will be the open loop transfer function. From open loop transfer function we can easily determine what will be the closed loop transfer function. Once closed loop transfer function is known, we can design what will be the PI controller to achieve certain performance requirements. Okay. So armature circuit, from the armature circuit we can write VA will be RA plus LA DIA or DT plus EA. So this voltage is equal to drop in this and back EMF voltage. So VA is equal to RA IA plus LA DIA or DT plus EA. So and the induced back EMF, you know that it is proportional to the product of flux and speed. So EA is equal to K is a constant, phi into omega. So if we substitute this value in first equation, so VA will be RA IA plus LA DIA or DT plus K phi omega. So we are getting this equation. Also we know that motor torque will be equal to load torque plus dynamic component plus viscous friction. Okay, B time omega. Other frictions, they are very small in comparison to the viscous friction, so we are neglecting those components. And induced torque is torque, that is motor torque, it is proportional to flux into armature current. So T is equal to K times phi Ia. Okay. Now we are having these equations. We have to take Laplace transform to obtain the transfer functions. So first equation, rather this equation, if we take Laplace transform, so this will be VAS RA IAS plus LA. So Laplace transform of this equation will be S time IAS. Okay. Plus K phi omega S. So we are getting this equation. Similarly, from back EMF equation, that is K phi omega, we have to take Laplace. So that will become EAS will be K phi omega S. Okay. Similarly, this equation, if we take the Laplace, so this side will become TS, is equal to TLS plus J d omega over dt, that will become S time omega. Okay. Plus B omega S. Similarly, from this torque equation, we can take Laplace. So TS will be K phi IAS. In this Laplace transform, actually, we have taken initial conditions to be 0. Okay. Now we will do certain arrangement to obtain the transfer function. So if we subtract these two equations, first two equations, if we subtract, so VAS minus EAS, so this side, this term and this term will be cancelled. So we will get VAS minus EAS is equal to RA. If we take IA common, so RA plus SLA. Okay. And divide this side, so we will get what will be the armature current. So armature current is VAS minus EAS. So we can take again RA common. So was 1 plus S LA upon RA. LA upon RA is nothing but electrical time constant. Okay, so that we represent by tau A. Okay, so again we can substitute back EMF value from this equation. So K phi omega S, that is back EMF. K phi omega S I had substituted here. RA 1 plus S tau A. Okay. Similarly, from next two equations, these two equations, we can drive the second equation. Okay. So we can substitute here what will be TS value, then TS minus TLS, we can find what will be omega S. Omega S we can take common from here and we can find that. Okay. So omega S will be TS minus TLS B time 1 plus J JB. Okay. So J upon B is actually called as mechanical time constant of the motor. Okay. TA we call as electrical time constant, and tau A we call electrical time constant, and tau M we call mechanical time constant. Okay. Now from these two equations we can derive this transfer function. Okay. So you can see here, this is the actual speed that we are getting. If you multiply this by K phi, phi we are taking constant because we are not taking control on the field side. So phi is a constant value. So this number actually is a constant number. So if you multiply this, we are getting back EMF. Okay. So this EA. So you can see from this equation, VA minus EA, if we subtract VA minus EA, and we multiply 1 upon RA into 1 plus S tau A, we will get IAS. So IAS we are getting here. Okay. So this is nothing but VAS minus EAS times this number. So we are having this equation. Okay. Once IAS is known, we can find what will be the torque. So K phi again is a constant. If you multiply IAS, we will get TS. Okay. Once we got TS, we subtract TLS and multiply by this, we will get the speed. So speed we are getting 1 upon B time 1 plus S tau M. If multiply this, so TS minus TLS multiply by this will give the speed. Okay. So this is open loop blocks. So from the equations we can convert into block representation. Okay. Now, if you want to find what will be the transfer function, so in transfer function, you can see from here, we are having two disturbances. One is here, another is this one. So first I will take this zero and I will calculate transfer function. Then I will take this zero and again I will calculate the transfer function. So transfer function is gs upon 1 plus gshs. Gs I am calling this this transfer function. You can see here it is gs. Feedback I am calling as hs. So transfer function we can get gs upon 1 plus gshs. Okay. So torque I am taking constant. So output is omega s. Input is vas. You can see from here. You can see from this equation. If this is 0, so output is omega s, input is VAS, armature side voltage, okay. So omega s upon VAS, GS upon 1 plus GSHS. GS you can find, these three blocks are in cascade. If you remove this, so these three blocks in cascade, you have to get one equivalent transfer function block. So you have to multiply these blocks, okay. If you multiply these three blocks, you will get one equivalent transfer function block because this TL is 0. Okay. So substitute that value. So this will be simply K times phi upon RA 1 plus S tau A times B 1 plus S tau N. Okay. So I have this number after multiplication. 1 plus again GSHS, this number, and HS is K phi, that is constant. So simplify that blocks. So after simplification, you will get some constant s square plus s square times some number plus s times some constant again, then some constant number. So this is second order system. You can see from this. Okay. So it is clear that motor forms a second order system with inherent feedback. So this is omega s. So if you want to find what will be in terms of VRS, so we reference actually armature circuit voltage was some gain from the converter, then times R. So substitute here, we can find what will be the change in speed with respect to change in the reference voltage. Similarly, we can find what will be transfer function if we are having VR to be 0. VA to be 0 or VR to be 0, and with respect to the load torque, what will be the transfer function? Okay, if you are changing the load torque, how the drive will respond? Okay, so transfer function again from this block. So, in that equation, actually, we have to substitute. If we go back, so this in this equation, I am substituting this number to be 0. Okay. Now you can see these three will come in cascade. Okay. Then we are having input here and output here. So this will now become GS, HS. Okay. So if I go back. So this become HS. Three blocks, they come in cascade. And this is in forward, feed forward. So transfer function will be GS upon 1 minus GSHS because we are having one negative sign here. So substitute all these things. Again, these three are in a cascade, so you have to multiply these three blocks. So GS is 1 upon B times this feedback. Now having these blocks, multiply these all blocks, simplify it. So after simplification, you will find this again second order system. Okay, but here we are having one zero as well. So this is S term here. And s square times some constant like that. Okay. So if you want to find at a steady state what will be the transfer function, so in a steady state actually you have to substitute s to be 0. Okay. T tends to infinity, that means s to be 0. Final value theorem if you apply. So if I apply, if substitute s is equal to 0. In this equation, these two terms will be 0. This term is 0. So, simply 1 upon B times this number. Okay. So, this value. Similarly, we can find from first equation what will be the steady state transfer function value. Okay. Now, once you know the open loop transfer function, you can find what will be the closed loop transfer function. So, in open loop control system for separately excited DC motor may be changed to closed loop control system by attaching a speed sensor. So, one speed sensor, that is tacho generator, we have attached here, and the constant is KT. Okay. So, in previous block, I added one block here that will give you closed loop transfer function. Okay. The output of the sensor could be a tacho generator or a speed code encoder, which is proportional to the speed, is amplified by a factor KT that I have taken here and compared with a reference voltage VR to give an error signal VE. Okay. So, this error signal we are getting. The block diagram for this is shown in this figure. So, again you do the same thing. So, these two, you have to reduce the blocks, then simplify the blocks in the same fashion. So, you will get these equations. Okay. Similarly, you can find what will be the steady state values by substituting S to be 0. Okay. So, this was the last lecture of unit 2. Now, I will start unit 3 from the next class, where you will learn about the speed control of DC motors by having DC-DC converters. Thank you.